In this webcast, we want to consider which orbital interactions are most important. We're going to be led to the conclusion that it's the frontier orbitals, the highest occupied molecular orbital on one reactant, together with the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital on a second reactant, it's their interaction that's most important. Why are we going to be led to this conclusion? The reason has to do with the rule that's stated at the bottom. For a pair of interacting orbitals, the closer in energy those orbitals are, the greater will be the amount of splitting. The greater the amount of splitting, the greater the stabilizing energy that the pair of electrons that occupy those newly formed molecular orbitals will gain. Let's take a look at two cases. The case on the left is the FMO case, the frontier molecular orbital case. It involves the HOMO on one reactant with the LUMO on another reactant. Then we'll take a look at a second case, the HOMO minus one on one reactant together with the LUMO plus one on a second reactant. So what we're concerned about in the first case is the energy difference between the highest occupied molecular orbital for molecule A and the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital on molecule B. It's that energy gap that determines the amount of splitting. That gap is quite a bit smaller than the gap that we see over here for the HOMO minus one and the LUMO plus one. As a consequence of this larger gap, the splitting is less in this case, and the amount of stabilization gained by these electrons from this pair of interacting orbitals is small in comparison to the amount of stabilizing energy that this pair of electrons gains from that frontier molecular orbital interaction. Now, in theory, we should have considered the alternative case, that is, the highest occupied molecular orbital on molecule B interacting with the lowest unoccupied orbital on molecule A. That pair of frontier orbitals also needs to be considered, but here we can see why that's less important than the case that we actually examined. Here you can see that the energy gap for this second example of frontier orbital interactions is larger than the case that we were examining before, which was the interaction that had a gap defined by that smaller distance compared to this one. So the frontier orbital, there's two possible frontier orbital interactions, and the one that we chose that involved the HOMO on A and the LUMO on B is the most important. In the next webcast, we're going to take a look at an equation that actually illustrates this point in quantitative detail.